I remember German soldiers near the wall catching young Jewish boys who had crawled through the cracks of the wall or jumped across the wall, obviously to get food, to bring something in for the family to eat. I remember them being caught. I remember the German soldiers having a contest by sicking dogs on them. They would let the children run, and after the child had run maybe 50 or 100 feet, they would unleash their dogs to see which dog would catch the child or the children first and tore them to pieces. I remember rifle practice of German soldiers, and I mean Wehrmacht soldiers, of again catching boys who had been caught going over or under the wall and letting them run as if in a sporty gesture, and then shooting them while running with what I found out later were explosive or dum-dum bullets. I remember incidents of women being stopped on the streets and then being stripped by German soldiers, by SS, who are clearly recognized, of being tied to lampposts and whipped, of elderly Jews being grabbed by their beards and thrown on the ground and having their beards ripped off them without even the use of scissors. I remember children searching garbage bags and looking for any remnant of food they could find. I remember hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of bodies lined up every day on the sidewalk of the ghetto, near the alleyways, and I would have to sometimes jump over them. And the way that I reacted to these bodies was to pretend that they were logs. And I was jumping over logs, I was jumping over trees. That enabled me to go on with this act. Luckily, children are armed with some very good imagination. And camouflaging it with trees was very helpful.